that saved the rich just like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Oh, you can't tell it.
Said in the last days, nations shall rise against nations, earthquakes in diverse places, famine and pestilence in all the land. He said, in the last days they'll come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, but don't go after them. For the saints, he said, when you see these things, don't be terrified, but look up, for your redemption draweth nigh. Real soon, Jesus is coming.
Real soon, Jesus is coming soon.
You better get your house in order.
Jesus is coming soon.
Maybe today and maybe tomorrow.
Jesus is coming soon.
I don't know exactly when it will be.
Jesus
done.
Is coming soon.
When he returns with him, I'm gonna live.
Jesus is coming soon.
Oh, real soon.
Real
Jesus
soon.
Is coming.
Jesus is coming soon.
Oh, real soon.
Real soon.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Jesus
yeah.
is coming.
You better get your house in order.
Jesus is coming soon.
It may be today and it may be tomorrow.
Jesus is coming soon.
I don't know exactly when it will be.
Jesus is coming soon.
When he returns with him, I'm gonna live.
Jesus is coming
real soon.
Real
yeah.
soon. Jesus is coming.
Signs of the time says it's coming, it's real near. Could be any day or any hour.
Hello, America.
This place was named after one of our political leader, Mr. Elias Motsoaledi, who was arrested together with Nelson Mandela, Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisulu in Robben Island. When he was released, he came back to the community to lead us, but unfortunately, he was sick, he couldn't last longer. And then when you lose a leader who is a freedom fighter or a politician, you must honor that person by calling your place or calling your property with his name. So then even if his spirit is not longer with us, but his name can remain forever and ever to generations to come. That is why today we are known as Elias Motsoaledi Informal Settlement. The government provided us with only 445 toilets for 15,000 to 20,000 people. And also the government provided us with only 25 water taps for 15,000 to 20,000 people. Okay, you said how many people are here?
Eight
people live here. Mm-hmm. Is your mother?
My parents and my sisters.
Are your brothers and your sisters? Mm-hmm. And then how long you been living here?
Oh.
Almost 22, 23 years?
Yeah, since from 1994.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's one of the, they were one of the families who first came to live here,
mm-hmm.
you see. And then, do you go to school?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, then, how do 8 people live here?
Yeah, we all live in this house, but our 4 people
on that share side. The bedroom on the other mm-hmm. side.
One here and
on the couch,
five.
And they need something comfortable like a mattress on the floor, so mm-hmm. the other kids can sleep comfortably mm-hmm. as well. Then we can take a photo then of the whole house and then see how it's arranged. It's nice and clean and neat.
Okay.
And then you take that, come to the side as well, see how's the bedroom and the wardrobes, all that, because that would be much, much important.
Mm-hmm.
This is the only wardrobe that we use most of the time, like, you know, this one, small one,
yeah.
and then this one for the shoes, and other ones as well.
Oh my goodness. I need one of these. For one person.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh my goodness. Goodness.
This is, you can see the pots are clean, nice.
Yeah.
You know, these are the stands.
That's your job.
Yes. This,
you do a good job.
Yes. Yeah. As you take care of the mother when the mother is not around. Mm-hmm. She must take care of everything.
Yes. That's nice.
You're getting used to everything. You know, we know when it's winter season, well, how can you cope? Because in the winter season, we must organize something called a brazier.
Mm-hmm.
Which is in an African language, we call it imbaula. It's a brazier. It's just a big container. You punch holes on the outside, and then you put wooden pieces on the inside, and then you're using papers, and then you can warm up the house, and you can feel warmth, especially in the winter season. And then during this time of the year, which is the summer season, it is very hot, very warm, and then you can use a brazier, and then you have to at least cope with the sun, and then the house is always warm every time.
Okay. What's your name again?
Tando Gazi and Kevin.
Tando Gazi and Kevin. Well, we appreciate you letting us into your home and visit with you.
Yeah, we get appreciate
getting a better understanding of your living conditions. We thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor. Pastor?